eventually get an axe, and that hero is very, very good with axe. The Lone just basically doesn't die if you have axe.
This is so scary. How
you
do
press
you...
R and everybody stops dying and you just do whatever?
You run through the trees.
Very difficult for TNC to fight into them. So their only solution right now I could see is they need to win the lanes. They need to have a similar to the last game. They need to get a bigger advantage out of the laning phase because they don't have good team fight. So when you don't have good team fight, you need items to compensate. So you need to win your lanes hard.
Like an episode of Yu-Gi-Oh, dude. They're falling into the trap card here. Right. They're trying to get all these aggressive heroes, and it's all defensive.
Yeah, it seems it's gonna be a support Nyx with the axe. That should be Sam H's hero.
That Nyx is really like throwing off, like, because it's usually like when you see that Nyx,
it doesn't counter anything though.
Yeah, you want it versus something specific, but just
Tinker, a Storm, you know, something like that.
Ember.
But I think this game is probably to throw the opponent off. They pick a kind of like an offlane hero, and then they transition him into a support, leading the enemy to think this is their offlane, and then drafting something different. But OG seem like they don't
Hello.
Chen.
That's new.
Group up and push, and more.
Good thing we didn't speculate about what Jarex was gonna play, because nobody would have said Chen.
Chen is actually quite good against Axe because of the heals you're gonna give to your team. So it makes it very difficult for the Axe to get a target onto critical level for Culling Blade.
Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but didn't Chen receive a little bit some nerfs? I mean, didn't they take down his burst damage? I know it's much harder to run Dagon Chen now.
Oh, yeah.
No one runs that anyway.
What do you mean, no one?
Get the hell.
Just saying.
I know.
I mean, maybe you do.
That strat is not so good these days.
I think it gives you more ways to protect the Lone Druid as well. It gives you, like, stronger lanes. It gives you a mech carrier. It gives you timing push as well as getting to later on.
I mean, the best build for Chen right now is actually not the mech build. When you play Chen, you want to get the helm into eggs.
Yeah, helm into eggs.
That's what my Chen player told me. Get the helm, get an extra creep, and then I want to build eggs. So I wish someone could build the mech for me.
That's why Fly's there, right? That's why the Warhawks.
Yeah, exactly.
10 seconds. Fly always builds those type of various... items, Lotus Orb, Glimmer, Mech.
TNC needs to win their lane so hard. Oh my god.
Okay, wait a second. I got a
versus
crazy
Chen,
idea.
Though.
Yeah, well, Chen is very good.
Crazy idea here, but we've been seeing Doom had some nice upgrades. You can eat the Chen creeps, make some more money.
Get a Midas. Kill it, the other creep.
Look at that. So
I'm expecting to see Doom this tournament. I mean, I was expecting to see from ROTK, perhaps.
Doom is really good against Helm of Dominator, because everyone, in every game, I think, almost every game you could see a Helm.
But for which team would you see the Doom?
I would see it for TNC, you know?
They need a carry.
The Raven Doom!
Come on, dude.
Oh, you're all laughing now.
If he picks Doom, they are doomed, you know? They are not going to pick Doom.
They're doomed.
Alright,
we'll see about that, my friend.
But what about the Terrorblade, Jake?
We've been talking a lot about the Terrorblade, and again, I feel like...
Would it still fit?
Could. I mean, Terrorblade's great against some Chen action. You just blow up all those creeps, make a lot of money.
Not so good for Centaur, though.
Yeah.
Okay.
Just very solid lanes. Yeah. They have minus armor now, and it's a very good matchup because right now you see in the 4th and the 5th pick, OG pick heroes that are really good in the lanes. They understand that first 3 picks, we have more than enough team fight. If we do well in the lanes, game is pretty much in the bag. So, TA 1v1 against Invoker, you have huge advantage there, and you have a Chen.
No great refraction breakers either.
Yeah, this is bad for TNC. Very difficult to draft.
You know who's great at breaking refraction? Doom! Scorched Earth is fantastic at getting rid of that.
Damn,
I thought you were going to say something like Viper or Venomous.
Oh,
I thought you
would
say Viper too.
Oh, yeah.
Shiva, help us.
I mean, if I'm supposed to help you with Viper and Venomous, I don't think that is going to be my role here.
Please, please, TNC.
Man, what are they going to pick? They need like a big carry hero though, but then the big carry hero can't really fight well early.
Yeah, you said that you needed you wanted to see Raven on the traditional carry.
Maybe Sven, I don't know. Like all those heroes are not very good. If you're talking about heroes that can gap close, there's Spectre, but he's very bad in the lane.
Can they go super green?
It's over.
There's still like the Juggernaut,
Rift King. I don't know what they can pick there.
Rift King.
They're gonna pick Doom.
Alright, you got 1 minute to convince us, Jake.
Jug, Terrorblade, I think those are the two standard ones.
Sure.
Very difficult to pick. No, like, good picks here.
Oh. Yeah, it's gonna be the Jug.
It's the Jug. Alright.
Good call, Fogged.
Fogged, you didn't like the draft previous game?
This game is more difficult.
I think TNC has a very hard, very hard game. I really like the last two picks, just like Winter mentioned. The Chen and the TA picks just secure the lanes a lot for OG. So,
lane circuit, game circuit, GG.
Yeah, yeah. So about think... lanes, apparently. All right.
Trying to find a universe where TNC wins this one. And I'm thinking maybe if they just make it to the late game, right? I mean, Chen falls off, doesn't he?
You weren't going to say if they picked Doom, they would have won the game.
Well, of course. I mean, duh. That was the missing puzzle piece. But with this draft, it will be a little harder without the Doom.
Well, let's see if TNC can still make it, even if they don't have the Doom. It is over to ODPixel and Merlini for game number two.
Thank you very much, Steve. Indeed. Game two now between OG and TNC. We've just seen the draft, Ben. Intro to the panel. Don't seem to have a lot of hope in what TNC's been bringing into the...
I second this.
But I'm going to say, Ben, I don't think this is as hard as game one looked. I mean, there's no Meepo, Ben, for that part. They do have ways to deal around it. They've got kind of this invoker, you know, that's going to be able to do a lot more than Jug was able to in kind of game one.
There's Lone
Druid,
though.
Have a safe lane.
Lone Druid is probably worse than Meepo.
Lone Druid, you'd rather go up against a Lone Druid, a Meepo than a Lone Druid in this current patch.
I mean, mostly depends on the lineup, but in as first pick material, I think like Lone Druid, like you can first pick a Lone Druid because he's good in most situations.
I mean, they're kind of in the whole draft to deal with it. And in terms of kind of getting to the back lines, I mean, TNC certainly do have ways to do so. And in fact, they've already started off with a great way. They'll get themselves first blood there. S4 going out alone. I don't know, Ben, we'll see, but I think TNC could pull some nice out with this draft.
It just looks really hard to actually get to him this game. There's Stampede, there's Savage Roar, there's Upheaval, there's Rock.
For sure. I mean, yeah, OG.
Traps.
And OG definitely have this kind of lineup as well that I can see. There's going to be this point where No-Tail's kind of on his own in a lane, and then you have the other four of them just diving towers. You know, Chen with a full army up, TA, as you said, Stampede. They've got a lot of ways that they can just run at TNC.
No-Tail does not split push though.
You think he'll join the fights each and every time?
He always joins the fight. That's what he's known for, man.
I guess. He kind of does both. I mean, well, when he's on the Meepo, at least. You know, last game, he was doing everything.
Dude,
he was on his own lane, and then bam, he was turning up to the fights.
Yeah.
But I guess you're right. With the Lone Druid, he's got to be...
Okay, with Juggernaut, Lone Druid, Razor, Viper.
He's like,
all
his buddies.
Heroes, he's always with his team. Yeah. I think that's one of their greatest strengths, is that they play together often.
They
like, do. Even the Meepo, like, Meepo was not split pushing very often last game. He'd, like, push out a couple of waves here and there, but nothing, you know, super, super ridiculous. I think the only exception is when he plays Anti-Major Naga. And, yeah, we'll see how this goes. So Lone Druid will be in a one-on-one situation versus the Axe.
Is that what he wants, or... like, who's getting the favorable lanes, you feel?
That's definitely fine for Lone Druid.
Yeah.
Lone Druid, the thing about it is you don't actually want him in a dual lane or a tri lane because you actually want his talents ASAP. He's only really good because of his level 10 and 15 talents, which are still pretty good post-nerfs. He only got a 25 attack range nerf, which is hardly noticeable, and only a 10 damage nerf on his 15 talent. So he's not nerfed into the ground as some people may have expected.
Top lane. Raven and Tim's going in on to Fly. Immediately tries for a TP out, but they've grabbed him. And the three of them, they've found it. Fly's out. S4. He's going to be fine, but TNC already picking up the second kill of the game here. The support's doing work.
As Winter said, win the lanes, win the game. Right, that's at least what TNC is hoping for right now. I think overall in the teamfight, though, OG are slightly stronger, but in the laning phase, TNC certainly have the upper edge here as they need a lot of time, or OG needs a lot of time for them to actually get online. Unless JRX can do stuff with his chamber. Right now he's getting harassed out by Roar and Sims. He was not even able to finish off that Observer Ward. He might perish.
He might have to pop the Shrine to survive it. Fly, looks like the Shadow Word. Well, they're going to pop the Shrine nonetheless anyway to secure JRX's life.
And they denied the Observer Ward. 100 gold down the drain.
And Tim's Embryo sent packing back. Jarek's actually coming straight back across and actually looking towards the Rubik. I'm not going to have the follow-up damage there, just the Troll Trap, that's all. And over in the mid lane, Cuckoo versus Ana. 9 for 6 on the TA at the moment. Compared to the Evokers, 3 for 3. Ana is having an amazing opening here in this 1v1.
Very strong opening from him. He also went for the Cross Wex on Cuckoo. Or across X.
Oh, Jarax.
Nice.
He got the snipe there with the purple Hadouken of Doom.
I think that's so much damage now. It's crazy.
I bet Jarex is smiling about that one. We'll get OG their first kill onto the board here in this game, in this early game. Bottom lane. Until actually taking a fair bit of damage here with the Battle Hunger and the chase down from Sam H. And doing his best to kite it up with the bear on the front lines. Him sitting back and picking in those right clicks.
Sam H started off with, I think, 7 tangos in lane, which is a lot of regen, but it allows him to just constantly run at No-Tail, who doesn't have boots yet and is much lower in terms of regeneration. And Sam H able to utilize that pull. The pull, I think, is much stronger for X, as he can utilize those to spin more. Do a lot of damage to that bear.
Yeah, 12 for 3 against the 11 for 1, so both heroes getting something out of that bottom lane. Mid lane still, I mean, it really is just an incredibly impressive opening here for Mana.
Yeah.
13 for 12, he's pretty much hitting everything.
You'll see a lot of exorts on, Wexes on the Invoker, so they get the Alacrity up early.
Yeah.
So that he doesn't get destroyed super hard in lane like this. But the thing about Invoker is you can always jungle. Well, they're going on to Ana in the middle lane. Gets pulled back into a cold snap, and yep, he's dead.
Yeah, Cuckoo needed that. He needed that rotation, something to help.
Do you hear game sounds?
We don't, Ben.
Okay, I'm just confirming. Thought it might have been just me.
We don't need game sounds, Ben. Oh, they're giving them back to us anyway.
Great.
They're kind. They're generous in production.
You need game sounds, man. How else are you going to know all these things that happen in the game?
It's true, Ben. It helps out. Mid lane. Cuckoo, they got about half a wave done, mine is. And it was back to base there, thanks to that kill. We'll see if they can make anything happen up top. Dice4 just forcing Raven back. We'll see, realizing that the supports from TNC are out and elsewhere on the map. Don't quite get in that initial lockdown. Bottom lane, in fact, is going to be where TNC are going to be bringing in a second member. They've got their eyes towards No-Tail.
He has 1 point in the Savage Roar, though. It's very unlikely that they'll get a kill here.
Unless
both those things get done. Okay.
Yeah, indeed, as you mentioned, the Savage Roar immediately, in fact, getting the root as well, flies TP down. Look towards Sam H, but just a little too tanky to bring down. It is actually going to be in the middle lane where Cuckoo falls. And I had a DD. Jarex came in with the Chem rotation.
He's getting massacred in lane.
No, this is, you know, a lot of people do flame Ana for some of his performances, but this game is
pretty flawless. Are
you one of those?
I'm just kidding.
I'm not a flamer, Ben. I'm a lover, not a hater.
Only in your pubs.
Peace and love, Ben. Yeah.
Wow, that sounded... that was the most insincere thing I've ever heard you say.
Oh, dear.
Sounded like you just read that off a piece of paper.
Well, mid lane, Ben. Bit of the caster's curse kicking in. We talked him up. TNC immediately bring him back down. As a rotation comes through from Sam H. I don't think he would have been expecting that one there. And that kind of early movement from the Axe towards the mid lane. 5.5 minutes in.
I think a very important thing in this early game is that Chen's doing a lot. Chen is like such a hit or miss hero. Sometimes it's like,
yeah,
this Chen has no idea what he's doing. Sometimes it's...
Sometimes,
you know,
it's Jarex, and...
he'll get kills on multiple lanes. He's pressuring two lanes at once is the thing. He's like helping out the top lane. Like, they gave up, what, 2 kills at the start on the top lane?
They did, yes.
Yeah, essentially
get
first blood, and then Warlock died, and now it's kind of stabilized. Centaur is number one in CS, thanks to Jarex. And then in the mid lane, TA is crushing Invoker also because of the Chen experience.
Yeah, this is going to be really nice for us for the amount of money he's had. Those lanes are going to get very scary once he's able to start moving around and hopping in for a bit of action. I mean, he's still yet to pick up the Ring of Protection, I guess, because of how well this lane's going. He's like, all right, casual Ring of Regen, then save up for the Blink, or do you think he'll go for a Hood first? Do you get the Hood or Blink this situation?
On the
S4 Sentinel.
I usually do not see Blink first.
Oh, hello. Can they find him? Yes, they can. Swarm Fly closing the gap, and another kill on this top lane. S4 just having the time of his life here. I mean, overall, the net worth, as we can see.
Yeah, he'll go Blink him.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, 1500.
You can go Hood first, too. Hood first is always generally pretty decent.
Well, bottom lane, Cuckoo. I guess he's found him. It's going to be Jarex and Ana. They've found one. Samich will get the call onto Jarex. Jarex will be very happy paying with his life to get the kill onto the Invoker. A little less so, though, if Ana ends up going down as well. And he will be chased around here. TNC actually with 4 members on the hunt for this TA. I mean, Ana, he's just going to go for the TP out. In fact, he's not going to make it. Telekinesis is there in time. got the stun locked down. TNC surround him. And Anna, Fade Bolt to the back will do it. Rio takes him out. But it does take a fair bit of TNC's time, and obviously space created. No tail.
It really
is. Creeps down bottom.
Radiant has killed the top tower.
Yep.
More importantly, and like every one of their kills, it just seems like they need so many heroes to do so. They're up in kills, but in momentum, it seems like it is definitely going OG's way. And I think that was prior to No Tail really being able to do damage to tower with Demolish.
Yeah, absolutely. This is. He's tamping up. This is a little scary for TNC if they're losing one of these side lanes as such.
I wonder what build No-Tail's going. I'm looking at his quick buy, and it has phase Aquila. Aquila is something that I just don't see very often on Lone Druids. Usually you just see the Basilius to help push with towers. Aquila, agility is not that important for him. There's damage because of his talents, but we'll see.
Mid lane.
Wasn't that so much more satisfying with game sound, Owen?
I mean, yeah, that's a lovely sound, isn't it? The old Meteor.
It really is.
Jarex and No-Tail. Looking to pressure onto this mid tier one. As you've kind of already said, in this game, Jarex getting a lot done.
Yep.
Very, very nice start for.
See, No-Tail pushes with his team. It's just what he does.
It does.
He has a Blightstone with him. He has Demolish on Bear and Cuckoo. They just. The thing about taking down this tower is that it will make Cuckoo a lot more pressure when he tries to farm the Ancients.
Oh, I mean, the S4 wanted to go there. He stampedes, jumps in, Blink Who Stomp. Then the detect for Cuckoo doesn't look like they do, so he is going to be able to slowly ghost walk his way out of there.
I mean, they can just keep on taking down towers. Just keep chomping them down.
Raven has been given a bit of space down bottom, but Anna's in there.
There are just a lot of things you don't want online for TNC.
Yeah.
Midas Invoker slows down Chen a lot. Blink Dagger on the Axe, very, very important in this early game. Even a Midas on Nyx, I would say, would be pretty bad for them, although I think it'd be very risky to go for a Midas on him right now. Well, smoke gank coming around on the bottom side. Tims and Rior trying to kill old No-Tail. The thing about it is, if you don't stun the bear, he'll just return it and then Savage Roar.
I mean, it's hard to do. You know, Tim is still yet to have Vendetta. So they only have the cover of the smoke. There's not going to be that initial invis closed down. They do get the telekinesis onto No-Tail. They'll miss the stun, though. In fact, he may have been trying. I think he was trying to stun the bear so he couldn't Savage Roar, but still got out in time.
Savage Roar, very good spell.
Can't kill this No-Tail. And still, as we can see, just S4, 4.5k net worth at the moment. 2-4 CS. Cuckoo 500 or so away from the Midas.
Is he going for Dominator on the bear? I'm still not sure what No-Tail's going for. I see a ring. I see an Aquila.
He's got a bit of everything, hasn't he?
Yeah, he could be going for Midas. He could just be going for a casual ring. He could be going for... I don't think he's going... I just don't know what he's going. It says phase and it's quick buy, but after that, who knows, man. I feel like they could just get Helmet Dom and just end the game early. I'm pretty sure True Form into the buff buffs his summons as well. You used to see Necrobook sometimes on Lone Druid because of that. It's kind of like Lycan. But I don't actually know since it's been changed because I haven't seen a Helmet Dominator or a Necrobook on Lone Druid in ages. But No-Tail does do some pretty cool builds now and then.
Well, bottom lane S4 immediately into Sam H. Yeah, he's got the Berserker's Call to buy himself some time, but he still ends up going down. The damage too much from OG. They'll cut down
one. Did he the bear? Oh, 300. No-Tail. Or wait for Ana. Cuckoo.
Lose the tower though. And at mid lane as well, diving onto Cuckoo, talking about the man who's trying to get himself away. The stun will hold back the ETA, and in fact, TNC turned it around. Good backup there from the support. Rio getting himself in and allowing to turn that. Bottom lane though, OG is continuing to put this pressure on. They may have lost a court. They're looking to find a tier 2 in trade. Tims comes forward with the stun. Onto Jarax, but flies in the neighborhood. He does have Chaotic Offering. It's very hard for TNC to do anything about this tier 2 going down. I'll have to let it go. OG picking up yet another objective. And certainly keeping themselves ahead in terms of the overall net worth.
Yep, this is exactly how you play a Lone Druid Chen strat. You take down their towers before they can really do anything in the early game. And Midas is finally online from Invoker, and he didn't die due to the TA dive. So he's actually getting pretty decently up there in terms of net worth after his terrible early game. He is number 4, just 1,000 gold behind the Lone Druid, and just a little bit behind everyone else.
Lotus getting a little aggressive there with his farming, but looks like he can afford to do so, though, with Tim's not hitting the stun. That's a speedy little man there with the phase boots, and I like what it looks like to be that he is going to be doing Notel. He's got the Desolator queued up, so I mean, having a good timing on phase Deso, these pushes are going to be absolutely deadly, man.
Yeah, he doesn't actually need the extra range from Dragonlance this game, which is kind of weird to say, but they're not contesting the fights. So when you don't contest the fights, you don't really need the range for positioning. But Notail, will he get caught out by the blink over here? He is in bear form just in time.
Yeah, and TNC, they're scared. They don't want to jump into this. They come up to the high ground. Tim's, he's just going to start to walk straight back down. But S4's there, immediately blinks in onto the back lines, finds Ryo on the Rubick. The Rubick's out. Tim's will try and get himself away, but all the spells are used, slowed down by Jarex, cut down by S4. OG fine too. Sam, it's an absolutely beautiful call there, but the hand of God comes through. Jarex saving the team. S4's back in with a Blinker Hoof Stomp. They've got an Omni Slash, but that's an Omni Slash too little. There's Raven's out as well. S4 picks up the double kill. And a very, very nice turnaround there from OG, you know, where it looked like TNC might have been able to do something. They get a massive call and combo from the Invoker. But that Hand of God, that re-initiation from S4, just securing the fight yet again for OG. They get another tier 2. Just, I mean, we're only 14 minutes in, Ben, and we are seeing the strength from OG's draft here.
Yep. Indeed we are. And I think the panelists were talking a little bit about the next assassin pick. It's like, it doesn't counter anything that really that they have, and it's actually really bad against five men like this before you get any items. And I think, again, from the Juggernaut, we're seeing some perhaps questionable item builds. He went for Yasha first, and Helm of Dom is really good against Chen. Like, you take away one of his creeps like each and every time, and it's usually a pretty good creep, or else he wouldn't have it in the first place. And it's also really good against five men. Whereas Yasha is much better for farming, so split pushing, it's a little bit of damage, but like generally the Helm of Dom is a pretty good value here. But Raven disagrees and will proceed with the Yasha, which he has almost completed right now. Rubick inside the pit with an illusion, and looks like that will be No-Tail's next target. I do think it's a little bit strange that...
Oh, S4.
Oh, he's done.
I mean, these two boys, the kitty cat's out as well.
Oh, he has Vanguard as well. Oh my god, Centaurus farm.
I mean, yeah, he's dead. S4, he's rocking it.
Juggernaut's gonna have damage issues just like last game against a Centaur with a Crimson Guard.
No, I mean, he's gonna have more issues than just damage, Ben.
Yep. So, Notail looked like he queued up the Dezo earlier, but it wouldn't really make sense for them to get two Dezos when they already have one on Ana.
Well, that's true, actually. Ana, I mean, Ana's, you know, with the kills that he's been picking up and the farm that he's had, so...
I do like how he didn't get Lance, though.
Yes,
Lance
you
is
just
considered
there's
core.
No necessity for it in a game where you've got this momentum.
It actually slows you down, because the range is just not... Like, the stats are certainly good, but when you can just go Maelstrom and phase and no HP because you have this, like, gruesome team fight to back you up, like, you can get away with such a Glass Kennedy build. And I think they're about to knock on high ground, and it's going to take another big combo like that from Axe, from Invoker, to be able to stop some high ground siege. Are they going to push multiple lanes at once? Are they going to try and take a T3 and shrine? What is their next play?
I mean, yeah, if OG get a pick off or two, this could be an early end to this game too. OG was just so much sieging potential.
I think they want to wait for maybe an item or two. Like, the Centaur does not have his Crimson Guard yet because it's not picked up, and nor does the Templar Assassin actually have the Blink Dagger. So I think they can wait about a minute and a half and then go again. This chicken is about to deliver some good stuff. It's a hot package right there.
TNC. I mean, how good is their high ground defense at the moment, Ben?
The things they have going for them are the call into the meteor and shrines.
Yeah.
That's about as good as it gets for them right now. I think OG could end this game in the next 5 minutes or with the next push. But it is slightly risky because, like, calls that close to your T3 is sometimes very, very difficult, especially if Lone Druid is kind of up there. And, you know, Dragonlance is really good for sieging high ground, so you aren't in that callable range.
OG at the moment, just sweeping across the entire half of TNC's map, Timbs. It's actually going to be spotted out here. I was just fearing back, no tell.
Playing it safe.
Yeah, can't really go on his own.
S4 wrapping around from behind, Cuckoo immediately Ghost Walls. They do not have detection for him yet.
Let's see if they can find any of the back line instead. Do you get the vision on Sam H, who immediately blinks. S4, can he do it? Ooh. Not quite in time there. Just a little bit too far away.
They might as well try with the high ground push right now. They only have 2 minutes left on Aegis, and I don't really think they're going to get a better opportunity.
Oh, Jarax. Oh, man. My goodness, man. Oh, the sneaky Chen does it again.
That,
Jarax.
Oh, my God.
I mean, that was an invoker, Ben.
That's a poor invoker.
Oh,
he didn't
man.
Even get a chance to use his Midas. That is the worst feeling.
He didn't even get a chance to do anything.
Nope.
Jarax.
Yep, he can
micro. Jarax, it's... As you said, you know, Chen really is one of those heroes that can fall flat on his face, but this game, Jarax.
Still, breaching a T3 is going to be a difficult task unless you push three lanes at once. Chen creeps in bottom, everyone else in mid, and Lone Druid up top. So Axe Call is going to do minimal damage if it's only one hero, and I think this is a really smart approach by them. And they have TA in, like, kind of the most vulnerable lane with their teammates. Oh, Timbs cannot get the jump.
Can't lock down notes out. Anna being healed up by the Shadow Word mid lane.
They need to send this. Up. They need to heal this bear, but the TP's still on cooldown for the Spirit Bearer TP. He just passed it from the Lone Druid. So 5 seconds, then they can TP the bear back, and then they can do this again. T3 is still very healthy, though, I would say, on top lane and bottom lane, mid lane. A little bit worse for the wear. You know things are going well when you can drop your Tranquil Boots on the ground and not put it in your backpack.
Yeah, absolutely. Who needs the backpack, Ben?
Everybody else in the game. Everyone.
Oh dear, this game's certainly looking tough for TNC. I mean, you and the panel kind of called it. You did say that this one would be the tougher one out of the two that we've seen, and it certainly does feel like that so far.
Still, very close to Scepter on Invoker. I think he can actually do a lot of damage at that point. How is his levels looking? He's only level 12. Ooh.
I mean but
Meteor will still do a lot of damage.
Yeah, they do have the combat. A lot of it is down to, as you mentioned, kind of the Axe hitting those big blink calls.
Yep.
It's hard to do so. Aegis is gone now. Dire's bottom tower is under attack. So, OG, I mean, obviously, is. Even though they have this strength at this moment in time, it feels like, you know, there's not a lot of pressure on them to do anything soon. I mean, maybe... Yeah, I wouldn't even say the Chen falls behind because of just how far ahead kind of Jarax is of relative to a lot of Chens at this stage of the game. He's in a beautiful place.
I think it's slightly worrisome just because they did commit for 5-man items. Like, Warlock went for Arcanes. Doesn't have his Midas yet. You see the Chen, he went for Greaves instead of a greedier build with like a Helm of Tom and a Scepter, let's say, which scales much better in late game. Centaur, he went for the straight Crimson Guard and Blink Dagger, all team fight items for him. And I think the only one who has a really greedy build is No-Tail, but he doesn't have any HP, so they actually failed the high ground push, he could easily die. Or if he's caught out by a Nyx Assassin while he's being a little bit careless, and he could also die. So like, I don't think it's like super clear cut that TNC are going to lose if they are perched in this position for the next 5 or 10 minutes. Like, I don't think that OG can outfar them as hard as it may seem.
Okay. We'll see.
Got it. We had a little bit of message from the producer. Sorry about that. Ladies and gentlemen,
nothing's happening anyway at the moment.
Nothing is indeed happening right now.
I mean, TNC trying to, they did like maybe look like they were going to come out, but it's very hard for them to do so. And ooh, that's the courier out, Ben. And it's the courier down as well.
They could use a gem right now, I would think would actually be pretty good for them. And, you know, Centaur went for a Yules. he knows how to beat an axe with blade mail. That is actually kind of cool to see that you'll see your centaur build build Yules because they don't have another good Yules carrier.
Yeah.
That's actually really smart.
Certainly makes sense. I mean, it doesn't feel like they need the kind of the damage reduction as such from the axe anyway at the moment with the Greaves and the Hanukkah and Jarrax.
Yep.
They have already the offset for the damage.
I think a pipe would be okay too versus the Invoker, but I think the Yules is much more important. So Midas coming out for fly right now on that chicken, and still waiting and just constantly pinning TNC inside their base, waiting for them to slip up, waiting for them to get two-man hoof stomped, whereas Tim's and the rest of TNC just waiting for someone to be caught out of vision.
They try and go in, but immediately there's the Yules. Fly drops the rock, and already TNC falling incredibly low. Tim's is out. They'll move forward with the Stampede, look towards Sam H. OG pick up a second, his fly with a double kill, and Cuckoo just being forced back.
Okay, S4 was so fast with that Blink Yules.
They were not expecting that.
They weren't. It's also really good against Nyx when he carry phases, so you can actually catch their AoE spell.
Again, S4 just diving in. They'll set up another. There'll be a buyback coming out from the Invoker. Jarrax nukes down the Rubick. OG starting to put the pressure now into the high ground, into the base of TNC. They're taking down the tier 3 in the middle lane. Melee Rax in the middle, falling down very quickly as well, as Notel already looking towards the top. And in fact, looking for kills by the looks of it. Going in onto Raven, but immediately, in fact, with the stun, the Sunstrike, Notel falling down low. So on anyone catch him, Jarrax, he says, boy, get yourself back to bait. Sends him home. Sam H does come in with a call onto Ana. Ana kind of left behind here by the team, and he's going to get dunked down. So TNC will get themselves a big kill off the back of it. And they're not done yet. Tim's chasing down Jarrax here under the cover of Vendetta. Fly and S4 are in the neighborhood. They've got the sentry out as well. I'm going to look to jump back in on Tyrion though, Tim's. Carapacing will get the catch onto the Warlock here. And in fact, TNC, Sam H couldn't quite get the call in time. Immediate blink out from S4.
That was pretty greedy. Not going for that easy kill on the Warlock who's already stunned. Wanting to catch plus one, but gotta go for more sometimes.
TNC do hold. It did cost them the buyback on Cuckoo, of course. And they did lose the middle racks. A top rack stay alive. In fact, OG, though, they still want to fight. OG are inside the TNC jungle. TNC have to be careful. Damage will get the call here onto Jarrax. They'll surround them with Raven and Cuckoo. Jarrax, fate bolt to the back there from Rio. TNC will find that pesky Chen.
Two SNY in two games. Or one SNY in each of our two games.
I got buff bent. That, what was it, like plus 5% maim chance or something?
Something like that.
Something like that.
Something like that.
I mean, 5%. It's better than zero.
Thanks, Owen.
That's all right, Ben. Some EU maths for you there. Here we go, catching out. In fact, that's a great cool setup, but S4, he tries to come in, but it might actually cost him his life. He'll get the Who Stomp out, starts to back away.
He didn't get his BKB off.
OG, he's going to be a bit careful now. TNC, they are able to kind of jump in, get these pickoffs.
And now they're going to try and threaten Roche. The problem is Cuckoo actually does not have any mana. There is no Shrine up, so if they want to take a fight, Cuckoo's only going to be able to drop one or two spells. Sam H poised outside, ready, but Raven's like, I don't have enough damage for this.
Taking Roche seems a little risky at the moment for TNC.
Yeah, even with the DD, it's just not... Oh, the fake back!
Oh, that's sexy.
And if they can get the kill on No-Tail here before he's level 20, this may be a pretty big window for them. They do have the DD that was popped on Juggernaut.
OG's not going to expect this.
I don't think they're going to expect this. Flies in there. He does have the rock available. They are smoked S4
nodes. Is he going to get it soon enough? I mean, they've already managed to catch out on the sidelines. No-Tail, Hand of God's not going to be enough to save, and No-Tail's out. They will drop the rock here. Is it going to be enough to hold back TNC? Cuckoo's incredibly low still. He does have to get himself out of this one. S4 comes in with a Stampede, the Blink, Who Stomp, and Double Edge to clean out the Invoker. And is looking towards Sam H. Tim's with the stun to hold back the TA. They've lost the Rubick as well, so OG do find two kills. They get themselves anything more, that's the question. I mean, they're without No-Tail for 40 seconds. They don't need him to take down Roche, that's for sure, with the amount of damage that Ana's packing with that Desolator. So at the end of the day, it does end up costing TNC. You know, they lose the fight.
That was a really nice
attempt,
though.
And they lose
though.
The Roshan.
I do like that fake smoke or fake back into smoking.
It nearly worked.
It really nearly worked. If they had a DD, though, it would have been, like, very little chance. But OG are kind of wise to TNC's ways, and they know that there are very few ways that they can get back into the game, and they have to go for some crazy, crazy stuff like that.
Yeah, and if Cuckoo was in a better shape to fight there as well, it could have been a bit of a different story.
Yep. If only they had Chen Sen back, into BOT's back, that would have been great.
And control of that part of the map is going to get even harder now for TNC now that OG have knocked down the shrine.
They've gone for more fighting items too. Not only is the BKB up on Temple Assistant, it is also up on No Tails. So it's even more important that they get the Blink Call off than before into multiple stun locks.
Well, Tim's was able to find the setup there. Hunted down the Chen.
Easy Sunstrike.
And in fact, Sam H, he's also found a bit of a setup here as well. He's looked towards No Tail, Stampede immediately. They're trying to get him out, but Tim's, he's there with a great stun. Catching him out, the Omni Slash bounces aren't great. Ends up jumping towards the bear. No Tail BKBs and runs himself away. And in fact, they end up losing Raven, who gets taken down by Anna, who's just turned up at the back lines of this fight. And it's TNC that once again have to start to get themselves back to their base.
That was so unlucky on those Omni Slash bounces.
Yeah,
oh my goodness.
If that bounced on No Tail, it may have just been enough to kill him.
He even four-stepped the bear instead of the hero. So that was probably the best chance they're going to get at killing Lone Druid for the rest of the game.
And TNC now with three down, no buybacks. OG could once again be in a position to take down a second set of racks here as they move towards the bottom lane. S4 very close to having the money he needs to get the completed Aghanims. And at that point, it's going to be even harder for TNC to find an opening to get a successful team fight done. Cuckoo will do his best to hold off the siege here from OG, but S4 immediately there with the initiation. I mean, he certainly has been having quite a game. I mean, just constantly blink who stomp after blink who stomp. He's always there with the setup when TNC don't quite expect it.
Man, he thought that Ice Wall was going to save him, but I'm pretty sure TA side-bladed him on the Ford Spirit. So, nice play from OG. That's a pretty difficult kill, because he had just used Tornado and EMP and Ice Wall, and he was like kind of positioning himself so you have to run through the Ice Wall to kill him. And OG played that perfectly.
20 seconds without him. And again, S4 just come in with a Who Stomp. They don't have enough damage, though, to bring down Sam H. He'll back himself away, but that does open the...
The Crimson Guard's about to wear off.
Yeah, I mean, can TNC get themselves into this one? It's all about Sam H and these Blink Calls.
What, Chen has Ags on top of his Greaves?
I mean, it's Jarex, but...
What? They have that big old Ancient Prowler
Shaman. That, dude, that's the scariest Ancient. That
it's
really,
pretty
really
scary.
Now, Tim's S4 is going to get in with the jump. There'll be a nice Tornado and EMP here as they try and hold back, but Fly drops the Golem. They've got the Stampede as well, trying to get out. It's actually getting stolen here by the Rubick, and that will allow TNC to save Sam H, get him back to the base. S4 tried to jump in to chase him down. TNC have lost the racks here on this bottom lane. Cuckoo controlling Anna for the time being, but he pops the BKB on the TA, turns towards Tim's. Tim's is out and down for 45 seconds. No buyback. Sam H as well could be in trouble as Anna blinks forward. Looking to chase him down. Will be held back by Rio with the telekinesis. And in fact, Anna is out of mana. Tornado comes through from Cuckoo. Do they have the follow through to bring him down? With the Burge and Raven on the playthrough, they'll cut down the TA once. Can they do it a second time, though? That's the question. It doesn't look like they can because OG, they're all back. They're ready to fight back in. Take down two, take down three. Sam H comes in with the call. There's no backup for this boy. He will get the kill, but it costs him his life.
One thing that I really like about OG is that they're really good about their item choices. Like Fly, he played the same hero this game and last game, but this game he has a much different build. He went for a Yules and a 4-step after the Midas instead of like the Lotus Orb that he got last game, because how many 4-step saves did we see that fight? That was like, what, 3 or 4? And I'm pretty sure he's the only one with 4-step on his team. So, that was all him.
I mean, at this point, TNC...
Just a matter of waiting for your base to get cleaned up.
It's very, very hard for them. I mean, we've seen them that just try their absolute best hit with the team fights, you know. Cuckoo hitting the combos.
But against the BKBs and the Greaves mech, like, they can't kill them before they pop their BKBs. And that's kind of all they have at the start of the fight. Like, Juggernaut is just not going to do anything, I think, because of the Crimson Guard. And also the massive amounts of heal.
As we can see, a huge net worth and experience advantage, of course, at the moment for OG. Tim's coming out.
Oh yeah, they have the Axe too on Centaur. Okay, man, no one's dying. As long as S4 doesn't get called.
What can they find here, Tim's? We'll get the stun onto the Warlock with the Sunstrike as well. A Samage comes in with the call. Does catch out. Fly. He will survive for the time being. A Tornado comes in. Crimson Guard as well. Yules himself up. The Greaves and the Hand of God coming through. Fly finally goes down. At TNC, they've lost one. Anna's starting to clean up even more here as he pops the BKB. Tim's tries to run. Spike Carapace and the stun will hold back the TA. TNC have lost two. Rion Tim's backing off to the side. Raven still alive as well on the back lines. Tim's hiding in the trees. S4 is hunting them down. And with the Yule set up, they'll certainly get the Nyx Assassin. A quick mail strike to the face from Ada.
Yeah, it took them so long to kill the Warlock. That's very sad.
And into the base, we see No-Tail already working his way through that final set of racks here on the top lane. The racks are down and into the tier 4s they go, OG. TNC, they have got one buyback available, but the other two heroes down without it. Tier 4s are falling. GG is called. And game 2 and the series going to OG, Ben. And I think that victory, OG, they can be very happy with that one. That was perfect execution from the draft to the closing moments. They had everything